In remote villages and hamlets all over India, a time-honored tradition continues when a patch of land is transformed into a stage and the beating of drums and cymbals tells the villagers that another performance is about to unfold. Dance drama, the colorful and vibrant medium through which myths and legends are told and retold, linking mind to mind, generation to generation. In a small village in the coastal state of Andhra Pradesh, one such form of dance drama has assumed classical proportions. The style takes its name from the village of its origin, Kuchipudi. One of its early patrons was the one-time Nawab of Golconda, Abul Hasan Tana Shah. In 1678, he donated the land of Kuchipudi to the Brahmins so that they could carry forward the traditions of the dance, whose literary depth and visual appeal had so enamored him. Kuchipudi is marked by vigour and vivacity. It is frequently performed by more than one dancer adopting the various roles in the story being enacted. 16th century India witnessed a spiritual movement which brought to prominence the bhakti or saint poets who believed in the worship of God through poetry, music and dance. Two saint poets who are believed to be the creators of what is today known as Kuchipudi were Tirtha Narayan and his disciple Sidhendra Yogi. Inspired by the legends of Lord Krishna, Sidhendra Yogi created the renowned composition Parijata Paharanam, which tells of the heroine Satyabhama, the second wife of Lord Krishna. In a stylized manner, the dance depicts Satyabhama's injured pride when she discovers that her lord has planted a beautiful tree for Rukmini, his first wife. This opera offers the challenging task to the dancer of portraying an entire gamut of feminine moods and emotions. To this day, every Kuchipudi dancer aspires to play and perfect the role of Satyabhama. Traditional training in Kuchipudi is a rigorous process. Students must learn Sanskrit and Telugu, the language of the region, and also acquire knowledge of the scriptures, apart from perfecting the technique of the dance itself. The process begins early, when the students are around 7 years of age, and continues for many years before they are allowed by their gurus to perform. In classrooms such as this, the depth and beauty of Kuchipudi continue to be handed down to a new generation.